Dear students, today we are going to study about the automotive transmission system. Especially we analyze the manual transmission. Okay, so these are our apparatus. Okay, so normally they are lot of variety of transmissions used in the automotive sector. So for an example, the manual transmission and automatic transmission, they are a semi-automatic transmission, and continuously variable transmission, that means CVT, that's mostly used in the front wheel vehicle, okay, front drive vehicle, okay. So the CVT transmission we study in other experiment. So now today we mainly study about the manual transmission. Okay, so normally this is for the automatic transmission. This is not our scope. Okay, so however I give a introduction for that automatic transmission. So here in the automatic transmission we don't require the, that means clutch, okay. So the clutch is replaced by the fluid coupling torque converter, okay. And then that's gear wheel arrangement also change. There is normal gear, is normal helical or normal simple gear arrangement is used in the manual transmission, but the automatic transmission there are called plenty this type of gears, plenty gears used in the automatic transmission, okay. So in the manual transmission there are three type of gear, okay. First is sliding mesh gearbox, constant mesh gearbox, and synchromesh gearbox. So these two type of gearbox, these two gearbox are widely used in the automobile, okay. So what we have, the main subject is in our experiment is synchromesh gearbox, okay. So first we study what is sliding mesh and constant mesh, then we study deeply about the synchromesh gearbox, okay. Okay, I am going to explain this three types of gears by a animation video. So you can see this is the car, okay. So it's a gear, engine, clutch. We already studied in our previous class, we studied the clutch, okay, clutch assembly. Here there's a clutch, then there are gearbox, okay. This this gearbox is resistant rear drive transmission, okay. These are rear wheels are connected to the power, okay. That front wheels are freely rotate, okay. So this is the differential, this is shaft, differential shaft, and this is the differential, okay. So this gearbox is change the speed and torque according to the gear selection, okay. Now so you can see these type of arrangements are there inside of the gearbox. There are a lot of gears, wheels. So this is the shaft, transmission, drive wheels, and engines. Why this gear use in automobile engine? You just think, if you, because this engine is produced because the piston piston is move upwards and downwards, okay, according to that a particular power, okay, a particular power is produced, okay. So just think, If there is no gearbox, what will happen? You start the engine, okay? And the engine give its full power to the shaft, okay? That means, that full power means, normally it gives, so the vehicles work 100 km per hour, okay? A vehicle maximum, okay? It can, we can drive that vehicle when the maximum speed is 100 km per hour, okay? For an example. So, when you start a vehicle without gearbox, what will happen? In the starting speed also 100 km per hour. Okay, there is no control. There is no speed control. Okay. That means, if we press the accelerator, the accelerator control a particular speed arrangement. That means, for an example, in the fifth gear, we can control by accelerator 70 to 100, for an example. So, okay. So, we cannot, the other thing, it's hard to reduce the brake, when reduce the admin speed, okay? Because you, the vehicle is normally running 100 km per hour, so there is no gear change, okay? Suddenly we press the brake, okay? It's very hard, because sometimes the our brake pad may get worn out, okay? Worn out means, that means or damage or something, okay? Because it's 100 km. So, the correct question is, if we running in the fifth gear, we have to reduce the gear, fourth or something, we reduce the gear, and then we need to press the brake. That's a correct condition. If any emergency condition, we cannot do, okay? Do that gear change, okay? So, transmission or the movement, we need to step by step, okay? Otherwise, when we start, it's going to high speed, okay? We cannot control the vehicle, okay? You just think, you start the vehicle, it's running the high speed, okay? When you release the clutch, it's running the high speed, okay? It's very dangerous. So, this gear is control the speed and torque, okay? Sometimes, okay, I will explain fairly. So, this is the example, okay? Okay, when the car is climb a hill or any this angular surface, okay, the car is, okay, what we'll need? Because this time we need high torque because of the gravity, okay, gravity force apply this side, okay. Okay, gravity force apply this side, so we need high torque. Not high speed, okay? High torque we need, high power. That means by high torque we need to climb this type of hill, okay? So, this is normally equation. This power is, the engine produce this power, okay? This power is not changed, okay? So, this torque multiply by speed is equal to power, okay? What will happen? We need high torque in this particular condition, okay? So, if we need maximum torque or high torque, what will happen? We have to reduce the speed. Because of that, we can balance this power, okay? This, we need to equal this power. So, if we reduce the torque, we have reduce by 10 times, what will happen? We have to, if we increase the torque by 10 times, we have to reduce the speed by 10 times, okay? So, when the high torque condition in the, this work, this transmission work, the low speed, oh, that time it produced the high torque, okay? So, in the first gear, normally in the first gear, we can get a high torque, okay? Then that in the first gear, there's a very low speed, okay? Some of the kills, so normally this type of kill, we normally use the first gear, okay? Sometimes in the angle is reduced, okay? This type of kill, okay? Sometimes this is first gear, this type of kill, sometimes we can try with the gear or the, with the second gear, okay, the second gear or something, because according to the torque, but we need high torque here. This torque also high, but compare with this, is this torque is less than this one, okay? This is less than this one, okay? So just think, if we in a row, we cannot control the speed, okay? The vehicle is only running with high speed, okay? That vehicle, we cannot use this type of condition, okay? This type of climb condition, this, because the vehicle only produce the high speed, okay? We cannot change the speed, okay? What will happen? We cannot get the high torque. That's why the mostly the gear box is very important in a vehicle, okay? So here low speed, in the low speed high torque is achieved, okay? This type of this is, you can see this type of, hey, this is a flat road, or sometimes there is an angle, but here there is no problem because the gravity also apply the same side, same direction. So there is no necessity or no need for the high torque, okay? So we can running the vehicle with high speed and low torque, okay? So this type of, we can use the fifth gear also, okay? We can use the high in the fifth or sixth gear, we can use this type of conditions, okay? So here you can see how this gear wheel rotates, okay? There are some teeters, okay? What will happen? This gear is rotated this way, this gear is rotated this way. Am I correct? Okay. Wait. Okay, as you can see. Okay. So here there are two wheels, okay? That means this wheel will start to rotate as per this wheel engagement. This wheels tend to rotate, okay? This wheel transmit the power to this wheel, okay? Sorry, this wheel transmit the power to this wheel, okay? So this wheel we call driver, okay? This is operator, driver. This is driven means this is drive by another wheel, okay? So this is driven, this is driver, or in the other words we can tell, this is the input wheel, this is output wheel, okay? This is output wheel. So here you can see what is gear ratio, okay? Gear ratio is means the output, okay? Output wheel to input wheel, number of teeth, okay? Number of teeth, okay? Teeth means this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, the total teeth, okay? The input teeth to, this is the output, okay? Output teeth. So you can see here the T1 means the number of teeth of number two wheel. T1 is the number of teeth For an example, T2 is now 10, 1, 2, 3. For an example, 10. Here, that is 35. Okay. So, the T1 teeth, number of teeth is 35. Okay. So, in the upside, that is output wheel, this output or ribbon wheel. Okay. The downside, that is driver or input wheel. Okay. That's mean number of teeth. T2 means number of teeth. N means speed. Okay. Just think which wheel wheel speed is high. Okay. This wheel or that wheel. You can think, okay, this is 35. For an example, I told 35 teeth. This is 10 teeth. Okay. What will happen? This wheel is large, this wheel is small. Okay. When this wheel is full, complete one rotation, fully rotate, one revolution. Okay. The 35 teeth are applied. Okay. When complete one revolution. That time this wheel rotate how many times? 3.5 times. Okay. Here you can see. 3.5 times. Okay. This cap 10 teeth. This is 35 teeth. Both teeth are messed or engaged. Okay. So what will happen? For example, this complete the one rotation. This wheel complete its three full rotation and half rotation, because we have to balance the 35 wheel. Okay, what will happen? This complete the 10, that's V2 here. Okay, so which speed is high? This wheel speed is high because when it's complete the one rotation, okay. That means RPM, revolution per minute. Oh, per minute it rotates. If rotate for an example, okay. That's no need to be measure that. This is the unit, okay. For the rotation here 3.5. So in the same time, it's complete one rotation. It complete the 3.5 rotation. So this speed, the small wheel speed is higher than the larger wheel. Okay. So you can see here, this is conversely. Okay. What will happen here? So this is if teeth are, okay. If the teeth are, T2, teeth are, if the number of teeth are high, T2, this is low, okay, number of teeth are low. So what will happen here? This N1 is high, N2 is low. Okay. Sorry. Here, okay. N1 is normally N1, not N1. Okay. For an example. Okay. So here T2, okay. T2 is number of teeth in the number 2 wheel. N2 wheel, the speed of number 2 wheel. Okay. So here the number of teeth is low. Okay. Number of teeth is low, T2. They also speed is high. Okay. Here number of teeth of number 1 wheel is high because 35. Okay. It's high also. The speed is low. Okay. That's why we have to equal this equation. So this conversely, okay, conversely means here if T2 over T1 is, we have to change the is conversely changed because of this. When is increase, when T number is increase, the speed is reduced. Okay, that's why we change the this N1 is upside, N2 is downside. Okay, so we can use this equation. Okay, I will clearly explain later. The calculation part I will explain later. So you can, now you know the gear ratio, what is gear ratio. Okay. So the first gear type is slide mesh gear. Okay, the first type. So what is slide mesh? You can see here. Okay, normally we can see in the gear this type of three different shaft. That is input shaft, output shaft. This is called counter shaft. Okay, so the main shaft is these two one here, that is connect with the engine. Okay, here engine, clutch, engine, everything. Okay, here it is connect with the transmission, differential or something. So the power is sometimes transmitted through this shaft, or sometimes is transmit through this shaft. Okay, however it can transmit according the gear arrangement or gear selection. So this input shaft, we can tell this is input shaft, or we can call the primary shaft. Okay, this is primary shaft, this is output shaft or the main shaft. Okay, this is the main shaft. This is, we can call counter shaft or lay shaft. LAY shaft. Okay, lay shaft. This is primary shaft. The other name, okay? Primary shaft. This is main shaft. Okay. So this slide mesh gearbox, how it works? Okay. Normally it rotates. When the first gear, okay, we can normally call, okay, here. These two type gears are normally called the neutral gear or constant mesh gear. Always these two gears are mesh. Okay, mesh means they're already always disconnected. Okay, so you would know the power is transmitted from this shaft to, and this is, and the output is here. Okay, this is connected with the differential or other shaft. The output is here. Oh, so the when the neutral condition, okay, when the neutral condition, okay, when the neutral condition and the engine is working but the wheels are not rotating in the neutral, okay, neutral gear, what happened? This wheel is rotate, and according to this both wheels are rotates. Okay, and here this power, sir, these two wheels are not connected. Okay, this is now connected. That time these two wheels are not connected. Okay, for an exam these wheels are come to like this. Okay, this move to like this. So what will happen? The neutral gear, this shaft rotates, this wheel two are rotate. Okay, and this shaft is rotate, but there is no connection with this shaft. So this shaft normally rotates, okay, because this both ends are connected. This is engine, this is the transmission shaft. Okay, So this wheel, this shaft is freely rotated. This is not connected to anywhere in this end. Okay, in this end, this is not connected to anywhere. Okay, so it's freely rotated. In the shaft is rotated, but the wheel in this shaft is not connected to with the wheel. Okay, this is connect with the wheel. Okay, this is connect with the wheel. These two wheel. This is not connect with the wheel. So when this shaft is rotated, there is no movement we cannot see in the vehicle. Okay. So the neutral gear normally working only this shaft. Okay, no transmitter power to transmit to gear this shaft. Okay, now you can see the first gear. However, these two gear wheels are always touching. Now you can see. Okay, this is the first gear. Okay, always these two gear wheels are connected. Okay, meshed. Okay, here these two gear wheels are connected. Okay, here they are two, no, not connected. So the power, the speed is come to like this. This power is transmitted by this rotation is transmitted by this gear wheel, and here this gear wheel is transmitted power to this gear wheel. So this is the input output gear. Okay, then so we can get a speed here. Okay, the speed change because this speed is different, this speed is different. This speed is high because of the teeth is low. See, number of teeth is low, so speed is high. Here speed is low. Then that speed transmitted to this wheel. Okay, this both wheels speed are same. Okay, then this both this wheels then again the speed is going to reduce. Okay, again is going to reduce. How? Because this wheels speed is high. Here a particular amount, for an example, this 35, this is 100 RPM, this again is going to 70 RPM because of the teeth. Okay, the teeth, the number of teeth are higher, so the speed going to reduce. So in the here in the starting is 150. Okay, this wheel is rotated 150 RPM. For an example, okay, here is okay. Here it's 100 RPM. Okay, because this wheel have the higher number of teeth. Okay, so this wheel RPM is reduced by the teeth arrangement. Then this wheel is connected to this shaft. This wheel is connected to the same shaft. Okay, the shaft is rotated. That speed is same. Rotation speed is same. So this 100 RPM. So this wheel solo 100 RPM. Then again, this wheel transmit the power to this wheel. Okay, that time what will happen? This teeth is high. So this again is going to reduce the RPM. Okay. So normally in the engine power is 150 RPM, for next speed is 150 RPM, so we can get 70 RPM in first gear. For an example, I told, okay. This is the way to reduce the power, reduce the speed, okay, according to the gear ratio or number of teeth. So this is first gear. This is second gear. Okay. Now these two wheels are disconnect. So these two wheels are mesh. That means these two wheels are related to second gear. At the same time, this is a slide mesh gear. This is the type of slide mesh. So you can see here, we already these type of grooves we studied in the clutch. Okay. The clutch blade you have to. The previous class we studied this type. This means spline teeth. So these wheels have the spline cub or female thread, and this is the spline. So this can move this way and that way onto the spline of the shaft. Okay, here this is fixed. This shaft are fixed in the this wheel are fixed in the shaft, fixed on the shaft. Okay. So, however, these two wheels are always engaged. Okay. So we can change these two wheels to change the gear. So now these two wheels are connected. So this is the second gear. So this normally. Now you can see. This is the third gear. What will happen? This input shaft and output are straightly connected here. So what will happen? This is connected. The engine power, the 100% engine power, transmitted to this side. Okay. Now this maximum power is sent to. Now that maximum power is utilized. Okay. That's not maximum speed is okay. We can get the maximum speed because in the here 150 rpm for example is straightly we can get here 150 rpm because there is no wheel connections. Okay, this shaft is connected, so this primary input shaft and output shaft working as a one shaft. Okay, one continuous shaft. So we can get here any wheels are linked with this third gear, only shaft connected straightly, so we can get this speed and torque by other side. Okay, these wheels are freely rotate. So this is the second gear, third gear. Okay, you can see. Now these wheels are not connect here. Okay, so these wheels cannot transmit the power. Okay, but here these wheels are to connected, but these wheels are cannot going transmit the power to this shaft, main shaft, because there is no connection here. Okay, so this wheel is freely rotate. So this is shaft are connected, so straightly this power is. That I told the neutral condition, this is same as the neutral condition, neutral gear. That time, this shaft is not connected, okay? This shaft is not connected, so its power is rotated, these wheels are rotated like this, and these wheels not connected with each other. So this shaft is rotated freely. That is neutral gear. So this is the third gear. Because this type of vehicle have maximum, the gear is have a third gear is the maximum. Gear, okay. So that time we can get a high speed output. Okay. So these gear wheels are used to change the power, speed and torque. Okay, change the speed and torque. So this type of gearbox is a slide mesh gearbox. But here we can get some restriction or disadvantage. These type of gears are very noisy, the sound, okay, is noisy. We can get a rattle sound or noisy sound when we move this gear onto the splines. Okay, complex operation, we need a high force to move these wheels. And it's a complex operation. That's why the slide mesh gearbox is a basic gearbox. Now these days, this slide mesh gearbox is not used. So I already told because of the arrangement. So this is the constant mesh transmission. Okay. This is a type 2. You can see here, this is also same, but this gear wheels are fixed firmly with the shaft, but here these three gear wheels are gap. They are a clearance or loose gap, okay? So what is left? This gear wheels are rotate freely, okay? There is no connection with the shaft. The shaft is rotated a particular amount of speed. This gear wheels are rotated a particular amount of that not same, okay? Okay, this both speed are not same because according to the wheel, this wheel rotation, this gear wheels are rotate speed, okay? This speed n, okay? For an example, this speed is n, okay? But this shaft is not rotated at the speed n because both are not connected. There is a clearance gap, okay? So this shaft is rotated at the other speed, okay? That means p, okay? Both speed are not same. So here there is a connector. This is called hypothetical connector, or other word, the dog, dog, dog clutch, dog clutch. This is dog clutch or hypothetical connector used here. What is the work of this operation of this hypothetical connector? So there is a gap here, okay? This is the connector, okay? This connector is move this word and lock the wheel, okay? Move to inside, okay? Between the shaft and this gap of this gear wheel, okay? Speed gear wheel. So it's going to inside and it's locked the gear and shaft, okay? Then this gear wheels rotate with the same with the shaft speed, okay? So this also rotate n, this also rotate the n speed, okay? After it's locking, okay? So when the first gear is locked, this gear wheel, that time, okay, the power is transmitted. This always connected is power through this gear wheel, okay? This is first gear. So in the second gear, so this hypothetical connector is need for separate individual hypothetical connector need for each wheel, okay? This wheel need the hypothetical connector, this wheel also need the hypothetical connector. Normal time it's not engaged. When we shift the third gear, it's connect, okay? This will lock with this wheel, okay? Now this is third gear, and fourth gear the same task. The shaft is straightly connected here, okay? So this is the third type. This is called synchromesh gear, okay? Synchromesh gear. So this is the third type gear, manual transmission. So here you can see this is the main shaft or output shaft. Output shaft speed gear, okay? We call the speed gear. Gears are like this, okay? That means this is the teeth, okay? This is the normal teeth, but these teeth are not straight line, okay? This is straight, this is like an angle, okay? This teeth are angle, this angle. So we can call this an angle teeth or calical cut teeth, okay? Calical, okay? Calical, it's CL, calical cut teeth, okay? So this is the straight teeth, okay? And here you can see a surface, flat, it's a friction cone. It's the conical face surface. We can call this a friction cone, okay? Oh, there is other part. So this is the speed gear, okay? This is the angle teeth, calical teeth. This is the clutch, we call this the clutching teeth. And this is a conical face surface. Okay, this is we call the synchronizer hub, HUB, synchronizer hub. Okay, this hub have teeth. Okay, this splines. This is a design of splines teeth. Okay, here this hub and this shaft is firmly connected. Okay, grab firmly. Okay, this shaft. So this synchronizer, this hub and shaft are rotate at the same speed. Okay, how it connected? On this shaft there is a spline thread. Okay, spline thread. So the same as the clutch plate. This inside of this here also have the thread. Okay, inside of this connect with this side. Okay, so it fit on the shaft and rotate and is lead to rotate. Okay, so we can move this shaft this way and this way. We cannot do individually or separately. Okay, because this hub is fit with this shaft. Okay, but here inside of here that's freely rotate. Okay, this speed gear is not grip with this hole with this shaft. So the shaft is rotated speed, this speed gear is rotated another speed. Okay, this is connect together, this is not connect together. Okay, so this is the sleeve. You can see there, this is synchronizer hub, this is synchronizer sleeve. So there is a teeth. So the teeth, this is the male teeth, this is the female inside teeth. So the both are connect. Okay, so we can move this sleeve to this way or this way onto these splines. Okay, but we cannot move by this rotation. Okay, we cannot move because the splines are fit together. Okay, so it's rotated at the same thing. Okay, we cannot move this sleeves separately, we cannot do this. Okay, okay, it's more like this. Okay, here this is a speed gear. Okay, this is in the main shaft. So here in the counter shaft here, okay, there is another wheel. That wheel will connect with this gear. Okay, this is the counter shaft, this is the output shaft. Okay, input shaft. Okay, input shaft is straight here. Okay, there is a gear wheel, there is, okay, and here also gear wheel. Input shaft is here, this is the gear wheel, there is a gear wheel here, and this is the counter shaft. Okay, this wheels also rotate, this wheels also rotate, but the same time this speed gear is not connected with the shaft, so it's rotate freely. Okay, it's rotate freely. So what is the work or operation function of this synchronized sleeve and hub? Okay, this hub and sleeves are connect with this shaft. Okay, so but this wheel is freely rotated. Okay, what will happen? You can see here this thread, this is also have a same thread. This angle thread is used to connect with the with another wheel in the counter shaft. Okay, so now you can see we can move this way the sleeve. So this sleeve connected with the clutching teeth of small teeth, this small teeth, teeth of the gear, speed gear and the synchronizer hub. So okay, so now the work of the synchronizer is function of this, it connected two rotating objects, okay, and it maintained the same speed rate. Now this speed this speed gear rate lock, it's locked the each thing, okay, the both things are locked by this sleeve, okay, synchronous sleeve. So the speed gear and this synchronized hub and the shaft, the three things are rotated at the same speed, okay. So it's a locking mechanism. Now you can see, okay, so it is a locking mechanism, but the problem is, you just think, okay, this speed gear is connected with the another gear in the counter shaft or lathe shaft, okay. So when the wheel in the this wheel is rotate, the input wheel is rotate, the out, this is output, this speed gear also rotate speed, okay. That time this shaft and this inside of this synchronizer hub also rotate at other speed, okay. Okay, that both speed are not same, okay. This speed is and this speed is normally, this speed is normally high because this tightly connect with another gear in the gear wheels or rotate. So this also rotate, this rotates at higher speed, higher than the speed of the shaft speed, okay. Here the shaft is no connection, here shaft is the highest, the shaft is rotate the lower speed, okay, lower speed, and this is higher speed, okay. So when going to lock out, okay, when the this synchronous sleeve is going to lock out, this hub and shaft is different speed and this is high speed, what will happen, it's hard to lock, it's hard to lock, okay, because this speed is, there are two wheels, okay, there are two wheels, this is a sleeve, this is a sleeve locked with here, but this speed is different, this speed is different, okay. So we have to move the sleeve here and we have to lock here, okay, lock here, and this it may, it's meant to maintain the same speed of each wheel, okay. So it's very hard. So when we rotating two wheels, but the two wheels are not and have the is no have not the same speed, okay. So this locking mechanism is very complex and hard, okay, because this is this, the both the speeds are different, okay. So because of that, okay, there is another part, this is called synchronizer ring or synchronizer blocker ring, okay. So here this is the friction material inside of this, okay. Here fixed between the speed gear and synchronizer hub, okay. So what will happen, there's a flexible thing, but this synchronizer ring also have the same teeth like this speed gear, okay, this same teeth. So but this is this synchronizer ring is interconnect with this synchronizer hub, okay, because they are we call their component is synchronizer key, they are lock, okay, this is locked with this hub, okay, this is directly locked with this hub, but it can move little bit this way and that way, okay, they are flexible movement, because but it's locked with this hub, okay, it cannot move a few space, okay, can move until a few space, okay. So we can, it can move free little bit, it says there's a small play, okay, move this word and that words, but it can, it's normally connect with this hub, okay. So what will happen is connect, so it connect with the hub. So what will happen, this rotate different speed, but this shaft, this hub and this ring rotate the same speed, okay. This is, these three things rotate the same speed, okay. This is different speed. So when we push the, move the sleeve, okay, first this sleeve going to lock with this synchronizer ring, okay. Then is push the, this synchronizer ring push this word and it starts with the gear wheel. What will happen that time, okay, this is like a secondary teeth, this is the primary teeth, this is the secondary teeth. When we push the so the sleeve is first connected with the, this synchronizer blocker, this ring, synchronizer ring teeth, okay. Then is moved to touch with the surface of the gear, speed gear, okay. Now this speed and that speed are need to balance, okay, because of this contact, surface contact, okay. Then what will happen? Now it's a smooth operation. This ring is used for the smooth operation. Otherwise, this speed is different. So suddenly we lock out the sleeve with this teeth. Okay, that is this is complex. So this is for use for the smooth operation. So the sleeve is first locked with this ring. Okay, then further it's move further to this clutching teeth of gear. Okay, so this is the use of the synchronizer ring. Now you can see so in the gearbox you can see, okay, this is for an example, this is first, second, third, fourth or something gear. But here this type of sleeve, okay, this synchronizer sleeve and these are the two, both said they are two rings, okay, synchronizer ring, and here two speed gear, and this is the helical teeth and this is the straight clutching teeth, the clutching teeth. So you can see, for an example, this is for the third gear, this is for the fourth gear, okay. So you can see there is common synchronizer sleeve and rings, synchronizer sleeve, okay, synchronizer hub and sleeve used for the two gear wheels, okay. These two speed gears are commonly connected, okay. There is a one synchronizer sleeve and hub used for two speed gears, okay. These three gear, third gear and fourth gears are used common, okay. That means we can move this word, the sleeve, we can lock this gear. When we move this word, we can lock this gear, okay. Here also there is two wheel, this is first, this is second gear. What will happen now, this is now is locked with the first gear, okay. When it's moved to this word, it's locked with the second gear. So, now third gear, now fourth gear is locked with the fourth gear. So we can clearly how this is the gear selector, okay. You can see the gear selector, the now it's in It's in the fourth gear, third gear, this third, second one. Okay, how we can change this gear according to that? This is the rod. Okay, this is a gear rod, and this is connect with this is a fork shifter. Okay, on the sleeve there is a service. Okay, flat service. Then the flat service is connect with the shift fork. Okay, this shift fork and shift fork further connect with the rod. Okay, gear rod, and it's finally connect with the gear selector. Okay, now you can see how in the gear changed. Okay, third, now neutral. Okay, now is push second and first. I again you can see. That's locked, that wheel is locked, third gear. This is one. So here there is no direct shaft connection for the fifth gear. So here there is used another wheel. Okay, that wheel is locked, right? Locked. So the fifth gear, the power is transmitted through this wheel and is going to like this. Now this gear is locked and go into this way. So some of the vehicle, this is the fifth gear. Some of the vehicle, this output shaft and input shaft are the directly connected for the fifth gear, the final gear. Okay, so the other thing, reverse gear. The reverse is movement is we have to change the movement, reverse movement. Okay, we have to change the reverse movement. Okay, how to we can change the reverse? What is reverse? So this is the gear. Okay, this is the input gear. Okay, for an example, that input gear is rotated like this. Okay, what will happen? It's rotated like this. This word. Okay. This is rotate this way. Okay, right? Though this gear is rotate this way, okay. That means you have to think here. The normal time there is a two wheel only, and the 1 to 5 gears normally use the three wheel. Okay, so just think about this wheel. Okay, don't think this third wheel. Okay, you just consider this wheel is connected with this wheel and this is connected with this large wheel. Okay, you just think about the normal condition gear 1 to 5. Okay, this is the shaft. Okay, this is the counter shaft, this is the output shaft. So what will happen? The counter shaft wheel is rotated like this. So counter shaft is rotated like this. So this output shaft is rotated like this, okay. So the normal 1 to 5th gears, okay, normally we can get the wheel rotation this way, okay, this may clockwise, okay. For an example, either this may, it may change the clockwise or counterclockwise. I just told this is clockwise, okay. So okay, here it's rotate, okay, for x, okay, here it is rotate clockwise from the input shaft, okay. Then again this wheel is rotate anti clockwise, okay, from the counter shaft. Here also that both wheels are connected in the one shaft, so this also rotate, okay, this also rotate the anti clockwise. Then again this rotation is changed to clockwise. So in the input shaft this is rotate clockwise, now output shaft is rotate the clockwise, okay. The both are rotates clockwise, okay. So this is the rotate for the forward vehicle is rotate the forward direction, okay, this anti clockwise. So however we have to change the final shaft rotation to anti clockwise, okay. That's why we can move the vehicle to backwards, okay. That's a reverse gear, okay. So what will happen, we have to add a extra gear wheel, okay. So here the reverse gear use the 3 gear wheels, okay. So what will happen, we use the extra gear, so again this gear wheels is changed to this, again this gear is changed to opposite direction, okay. That means, okay, this is for forward direction, okay, this is anti-clockwise. Now the main shaft is here, okay, just think, but that means there are extra wheel, this is the input wheel, this is the output wheel, between these two wheels there is another wheel we call idle gear. There is extra gear used here. So what will happen, there are totally 3 gear wheel, so the third gear rotate anti clockwise, okay, this rotate like this, this one this rotate this anti clockwise, okay. So now you can see this is the rotation for the forward movement of the vehicle, this is the reverse movement, okay. This rotation shaft final rotation is changed, direction of the rotation is changed, okay. This is a clockwise, this is a anti clockwise, okay. So they are in the gear, reverse gear there is 3 wheels used, okay. I think you got clearly, so now you can see. But here in the reverse gear there is no synchronized sleeve or hub, okay. It's this idle wheel, input wheel, output wheel, this idle wheel. So when we select the reverse gear, this idle wheel wheel is pushed to this word by this rod and shift fork, okay, shift fork, and is engaged with this input wheel and output wheel, okay. By because the reverse gear is normally we can reduce the gear, okay. We can reduce the neutral or first gear and then we change the reverse, okay. Normally we cannot normally do when we running in the fifth gear, normally we cannot change the reverse gear suddenly, okay. When we running in the fifth gear, normally we can't change the reverse gear suddenly, okay. We reduce the gear one by one, okay, one gear or neutral, then we have to neutral and then we have to change the reverse gear. That's why And this reverse gear is usually always we frequently we don't change the reverse gear, oh, with Gombia with other gears. Okay, we cannot change frequently. Yeah, this gear. That's why this gear wheel will straightly connect with this input wheel and output wheel. There is no synchronized mechanism. Okay, that's reverse. You can see this is connect with this here, and this rotation is transmitted to here. Okay, so we clearly studied about deeply clearly about the synchronized type gearbox. Okay, we study with the study the parts of the synchronized gear. So synchronizer must synchronize the to rotational of two speed. Synchronized means the word is means is maintain the same rate of the speed or anything torque. Okay, so to and its synchronizer must be mechanically locked the two rotating objects. Okay, it's going is locked the two rotational object. On the other hand, we lock the synchronizer other hand. If we lock the gears to rotating objects by the synchronizer, and the other thing, if the gear or need to change this the previous gear selector need to leave or eliminate from that gear selection. That means when it locked the two rotating object, when the gear is a particular gear, when we release that gear, that again we need to leave or we leave the two rotating objects. Okay, so is the synchronizer work is it normally connect the two rotating objects and it's again is need to leave from that two rotating objects. Okay, so they are saying engage or disengage. Okay, that goal in this part. So this smooth operation preventing the gear grinding, which is also known as gear clash. Gear grinding means that means you just think. Okay, when you apply the third gear, you change to fourth gear. That time that's third gear need to release and fourth gear need to apply. So sometimes in the first gear also applied at the time that the fourth gear also sometimes the same time the two gears are applied by the fault. Okay, what will happen that time? We can get the sound. Okay, rattle or grinding sound or gear clash. Gear clash mean at the same time the two gears are applied inside the gearbox. Okay, so this synchronous gearbox mechanism is avoid these type of errors or fault. So now you can see already I explained the animation. This is the synchronizer hub. Okay, synchronizer hub, you can see I told the shaft, it's rotated with the shaft. So this there is a splines. Okay, this splines. Okay, here also splines. Okay, this is the slot. Okay, I told tell it later. So this is connect with the shaft. The shaft also have the male spline threaded. This is a female threaded. So this connect with the shaft. So here also splines. So over this splines, the sleeve is synchronizer sleeve is connected over the sleeves. So there are the three slot. Okay, there is a gap slot. This slot for the synchronizer key. There is another component, so that's the synchronizer key. I explain later. So now you can see this is the hub. Okay, there is a thread, spline thread of the shaft, and this is cup is locked with the shaft. Okay, so here you can see this side of surface is flat. Oh, the hub, this side of surface is flat, and here on the other side you can see a raise. Okay, this not flat, this is a raise, raise in the surface, because the reason is we can fix this hub in the one side. Okay, this is mention notify the direction or site of the when we fix the hub, we can fix at one side. Okay, only this can fix the hub this way, not the other side. Okay, so this hub height already I already showed the slot, this type of three slot, one, there is a three slot. Okay, this three slot, this is for synchronizer key. Okay, I told there is a hole, it is called for synchronizer spring. Okay, synchronizer key, yeah, remember, it's for synchronizer spring. Okay, okay, remember this, I will explain it later. So this is the sleeve, this is fixed onto the synchronizer hub. Okay, inside of synchronizer hub, this is the sleeve. So this is a female thread. Okay, the synchronizer hub have male threaded, the female threaded. Here also you can see, okay, so there is a three gap here for the synchronizer key. So here the spline thread also have like this three different arrangement. Okay, to fix on the fix onto the synchronizer hub. Okay, so we line up and we can fit properly. So you can see in the inside of the synchronizer sleeve, there is a different cutoff. Okay, this cutoff is connect with the slot of the synchronizer key. I already shown the hub, there is a three slot. Okay, three gap. So this fixed with that gap. Okay, this is fixed with that gap. So in the both side, splines are removed here. Okay, so that means when we fixed that slot in the hub slot, okay, we can move this way and that way to align the correct position. Okay, that's why these splines are removed. Okay, this is fixed into the slot. Okay, synchronizer key slot, this is fixed. Okay, so we can move this way and this way to align. Okay, that's why these two, these are blank, or this is this two splines, this side two splines are eliminated. Okay, so especially there is a cut here. Okay, there is a cut. Okay, different this is the that two span. Here there is a different arrangement. Okay, this means for this arrangement is, okay, this is different. Okay, you can see other splines are different, but this is okay because of this arrangement. Okay, It hold the synchronizer hub firmly, okay? It's for holding, oh? Holding or lock with the synchronizer hub firmly because of this arrangement, okay? Arrangement. So this is the sleeve. Okay, here you can see this is the outside of the outside surface of the sleeve. So here you can see this flat surface is used for the shifter fork. Shifter fork means this is the gear rod, this is air, there is a shifter, okay? The shifter is hold with the sleeve, okay? This is the shifter fork, okay? This shifter fork is locked here, okay, this surface, okay. You can see the both side, both edges are, this is different and this is also different, okay. There is a thin line here. What's the reason? This is also same as the, that synchronous hub. This line is mentioned, what side we need to fix, we can fix the sleeve, okay. Okay, the sleeve only we can fix the one side, okay? The other side we cannot fix, okay? So this means the correct side of the sleeve, okay? Here you can, this is a speed gear, okay? This is a speed gear, I already saw. This is a helical or angle thread, okay? This is the clutching teeth, okay? Straight clutching teeth. This is a conical surface, face surface, I already told. Here that blocker ring is fixed here, this on this conical surface, okay? Oh, that is a helical teeth. It's a clutching teeth, conical face surface. So inside of this there is a needle bearing. Inside of this there is a needle bearing. So now you can see the sleeve is fixed on the, this sleeve is fixed on the hub, okay, synchronizer hub, okay, this word. So there is a needle bearing, okay, this is the needle bearing, okay, this is the speed gear, this is a speed gear, so there is a needle bearing. I already told the speed gear is freely rotate on the shaft, so there is no thread, but here the gear hump is, synchronizer hump is connected with the shaft by the spline thread, okay? That's why this hub and sleeve and shaft are rotate the same speed, okay? But this speed gear is rotate, freely rotate, okay? It's not gripped with the shaft. So this is the bearing, needle bearing, okay? This needle bearing is freely rotate on this new onto this needle bearing, okay? This speed gear is freely rotated, okay? That time the shaft is not rotated, okay? So this is a normal condition without a synchronized ring, okay? Synchronized ring. Synchronization, this is the clutching teeth, okay? This, when we move the sleeve, it's fixed with this clutching teeth, okay? That time the both are rotating the same speed. So here you can see this is a teeth, okay? This is the teeth of speed gear and this is the teeth of, the blue color is teeth of sleeve, okay? So that speed gear half speed gear have the teeth in the outside, okay? That's a male teeth, okay? But here the sleeves have the inside teeth, okay? That's female. The teeth is like this. When this is moved to this word, this teeth is fixed like this, okay? Okay. So this is the outside, this is the inside teeth, okay? When we move the sleeves, the correct locking condition is like, okay? It move until this position, okay? Is correctly locked, okay? But sometimes this is this here, if any friction or anywhere, this clutch is, this gear teeth is not fixed like this. It's normally it cannot move to until this position. Sometimes because of the friction or any other way, it can move until this. So it's also locked, but it's not firmly locked. If it come to here, it's firmly locked. Okay. So what will happen? It cannot move deeply this way. That time it cannot move deeply, then what will happen? This teeth, the gears are jump mean is not properly connected, missed, properly engaged, did not properly engaged, now not properly engaged. That time this slip, this teeth are slip, so firmly it's not, the sleeve is not grip or firmly engaged with the speed gear. Okay, so prevent this type of misunderstanding of preventing this type of interpretation or misunderstanding. Okay, what will happen? This synchronizer blocker ring is used. Okay, here you can see the blocker ring is, okay, these are the teeth, here the additional teeth. Okay, here inside of these there are some grooves. Okay, so already I told in the speed gear there is a conical surface. Okay, this fit with that conical surface. Okay, so these grooves are like a friction material, so it fit, it grip the conical surface. Okay, because of this groove arrangement, so this is a friction, it's increase the friction. Okay, between the two metal surface. Okay, so this is the synchronous ring, this surface arrangement. Okay, so it's fit with here, so inside of that groove it's firmly grip the conical surface of the speed gear. So you can see this is a calical teeth, this is a clutching teeth, and this is a primary. I already drew in the animation, this is a primary teeth, this is the secondary teeth. Okay, so firstly sleeve is connect with this teeth, then again further is connected with or mesh with this teeth. Okay, so this type of grooves, okay, I already drew for the friction, maintain high pressure. This also type of there are some fiber material used to increase the friction. This is like a brake shoe, this also friction material. These are some types of synchronizer ring. And the thing I already told, there is a slot, okay, in the hub and sleeve, everything I told, there is a slot for synchronizer key. The starting of this video, I told the synchronizer key. This is the synchronizer key. Okay, this is a synchronizer key. So what is the use of this synchronizer key? This is a hub. I told there is a three slot. Oh, this is for synchronizer key. This is the key, synchronizer key. Okay, there are three separate synchronizer key used for this three slot. Okay, and at the same time this synchronizer key is used to fitbit lockbit. This is a synchronizer ring, okay? So this end is locked with the synchronizer ring, okay? There are a special arrangement slot. So this synchronizer, he is here locked with the synchronizer ring. The other side is locked with the hub and sleeve, okay? The hub sleeves, they are allocated a sun space for this synchronizer key, okay? So this is a combined position, you can see clearly, okay? So you can see this is a sleeve here, this is the hub, okay? This is the hub, this is the sleeve, and this is the synchronizer ring, okay? So that time the other end is locked with the synchronizer ring, and here there is a space, the hub, there are the three slot, okay? You can see the one slot here, so there is a gap. So inside of these sleeves also have the gap, there is a special cutout, okay? So he is locked with the synchronizer ring, hub and sleeve, okay? That means this lock, we lock the three items, it connect the three items, so lock the three items together, okay? So at the same time, this synchronizer ring can move this way and this way, okay, flexibly until a certain amount of position, because this key is allowed to move this way and that way, but there is a limited distance, okay? There is a limited distance this synchronizer ring you can move this way and that way, okay? They are so flexible, okay, play. But so there is a limited distance it can move this up this way and that way, okay? So now you can see here that is speed gear, this is the clutching gear, this is the synchronizer thing, okay? And here also this is the shift fork, okay? This is the sleeve, and here also again there is a synchronizer ring, clutching gear and speed gear, okay? So it's normally have a small play. Here you can see that this ring is connect with this sleeve, this area is sleeve and hub. This ring is connect with this sleeve and hub by a synchronizer key. There's a three slot is connect with the synchronizer key, but it can move this way and that way in a limited distance, okay? It can move because there is the synchronizer is lock the synchronizer ring with the sleeve and hub, okay? So there is a small play, you can see the play, not this way. When we rotate the sleeve, this both synchronizer ring move at the same speed, okay? Same speed means is rotated at a single thing, okay? So this is okay. Now lock this word. Now this gear is locked with this wheel. So you can see here, I already told that this speed gear is freely connect with the shaft, okay? Okay, so it can rotate very fast, speed it can rotate very fastly, faster than this synchronizer hub or sleeve, okay? I already told. So you can see, no? It's speed is very fast. This is a synchronizer hub, that gear is now is locked, okay? Now sleeve is locked, so the both component speed are same now. Okay, now same. Okay. So this is the whole things I described in the video. That's in the in these notes. So here there is another gear transmission that's called transaxle or dual speed range. This is normally used in the electrics, okay, electric speed vehicle or hybrid vehicle. This type of transmission is used, but this is not in our scope, okay. So here, just for your knowledge, this type of because in the normal transmission, manual transmission, there is a separate bar, differential is separate and transaxle, everything is separate. But here the differential and other associate components of driven axle all are integrated the same assembly, okay, all are in the under the one assembly, okay, the one thing, okay, that there is no separated like the manual transmission or automatic transmission, okay. So here there's other thing. See, we already studied about what happened in the gearbox, okay, what is the surprise. But we don't know when we select the gear shifter, what will happen in the selector, okay. We all study about the gearbox, but there is another thing, there is a gear rod and other things, okay. So I describe the things by the photo. There is a two type of mechanism. Okay. Here, okay. So this is our gear, okay. Here we can change the gear. So finally the gear is, okay, connected with some three. You watched in the animation, there is a three rod, okay. The three dot related with the fifth rotor with one and second gear, third, fourth, and this is fifth and reverse, okay. That's nothing. So when we move this gear lever, what will happen? This rod move this word and that word, okay. This rod, okay, move this word and that word. I clearly explain before. Okay, this is okay. When we shift this gear, these are the rod, okay, gear rod, okay. So when he lock this gear, sometimes we have to, when we apply the first gear, that time this gear, we have to call this gear in a particular position, okay. Sometimes this gear rod can sometimes move, okay. So we have to call the, when we lock the first gear, this rod is need to hold firmly, okay. We have to maintain a particular position, okay, for and sometime while we are driving the first gear, okay. So in the rod, this is the one rod, okay. That means I only show only this rod, okay. There are three, okay, this type of three rod here, three or something. I only explain this rod, okay, this rod or the only one rod, okay. Here there is a rod. So there is some groove here, groove, that means groove, okay, there is a not a hole, okay, there is a groove. So you can see three groove, okay. For an example, first this is the first gear, this is the second gear, in the center neutral, okay. When we this word first and neutral, then this here, okay, this is the neutral, okay. Third, fourth, fifth, reverse, okay. You just think about the first gear, the this area is neutral, okay. So there is a three hole here, okay. This time when we move the rod, okay, normal time this ball is, the ball is with spring, okay. There is a ball spring, okay, there is a neutral position, the ball is fall into this groove, okay, into this groove, okay, there is a cut arrangement groove. So that time the gear is normally, it cannot move this rod is, when the vibration, vehicle vibration and other thing, the this rod is cannot move this side or that side because it's locked with here, okay. There's a neutral position, okay. When gear, okay, this is the first or third gear, first or second gear, when we change the gear, this, okay, when we change the gear, what will happen when we change the gear by gear lever, this rod is moved like this, okay. So that time only press in a gear, okay. So this move to this way by the force, okay, by the force, then this ball is locked into this hole, okay. Here that's mentioned, okay. For an example, this is the first gear, this is the neutral, this is the second gear, okay. Now you can see same area, you can see the groove, this groove, okay. When we change the rod, the rod groove is rope, the ball with spring is rope, fall into the this groove, the groove that is allocated for the first gear, okay, in the rod. So this is groove for second, this is for neutral, okay. And so this arm, this rod is have three, okay, for this channel three groove, 1, 2, 3, this is gear three groove, okay. So that time when we locking the first gear, okay, we can, when we lock the first gear, we can release the our hand, okay, from the gear lever, because it's locked with under this mechanism, okay, the ball and spring, okay. Then we change again, this is locked with the neutral, and change to other side, that's locked with the second gear, okay. So here you are seeing, we are sometimes in here, there is a three groove here, and the balls spring is located here, ball spring is located here, when is moved to this word, the ball is fall into this groove, again move, the ball is fall into this groove, okay. There's arrangement in the this rod, okay. So this is a ball spring mechanism, this is a ball spring mechanism to for the gear safety, okay. And the other thing you can see, there is a three, okay, for there is a three, 1, 2, 3 or something, three rod, okay, there is a three rod. Sometimes this rod and this rod can clash, okay, because of the friction or wear, sometimes this distance must may be reduced, okay, okay. For an example, okay, these two, let's say this gear sometimes move to this one, so sometimes they are confused because this is gear for 1 and 2, this is 3, 4, this is 3, 4, 5 reverse, okay. Sometimes the 3 and 5 gears may be clashed, okay, because we, however, we have to maintain a proper distance here, okay. So because there is a gear lock mechanism, okay, so here there is a interlock mechanism, okay? Interlock mechanism, okay? There is a interlock mechanism, you can see. There is a two type of mechanism here. One is ball spring, okay? That is maintain the correct gear position, 1, 2, 3. Here the another mechanism here. So this is normally used. There's a ball and spring here, ball and plunger, okay? Ball and plunger. So these three are the rod, okay? This rod, this type of gear rod. So here also there is another group of this cut, okay? There's a cut model, these type of grooves, okay? Here normally is a neutral position, okay? But here there is a three, here also, here both side, here this side, okay? And here if there is a three rod and two ball are used, okay? In the center there is a plunger. You already study your plunger, like a small type of cylinder or something, like a piston, okay? So here this is the center. Okay, this is the center, this one, huh? So three shaft. This is a shaft groove like this. Center. Okay. So ball, here also one ball, here also one ball, here there is a center a plunger, it's okay, there I erase the ball, okay. Okay, there is a plunger here. This plunger is, we can move this word or that word, okay? That means normally we can move, there is a ball here also, okay? Wait, okay. I explain clearly, wait. Okay, now you can see three shaft, okay. Okay. This is a plunger, okay? There's a plunger inside. Okay. There is a ball. Okay. This is a neutral position. The neutral position, this is a neutral position. So this plunger is touch with these balls, okay? Two balls and plunger touches, so this is a neutral position. When here we move to this foot, this shaft for the gears, okay, first gear, what will happen? This shaft move that word, so this groove is moved to here, okay? So that time what will happen? This groove is moved to here. Move here, so that time this is blocked, okay. This screw to move here. So there is a groove here. You can see there is a groove here, okay. Okay. There is a groove here. So the bolt, what will happen? So there is a groove, the bolt fitted like this. So there is no groove. So move the bolts move from this hole into this groove. Now there is no groove. The bolt is moved to this side. Okay. The bolt is moved to this side. Okay. So that time what happened? This plunger also moved to this side. Okay. Because there is no groove, so these bolts move or lock to this groove, okay. So this bolt is moved, lock this groove, okay. So the plunger is okay, move to here. Okay, that is here. Okay, so however this gap is maintained, okay, because of this bolt and flanger. Okay, here what happened? Here that central rod is moved to here. Okay, so there is a two groove here. Two groove is moved to here. Okay, so the plunger also move with the groove. Okay, so that time. Okay, this time, okay, here I explain here, okay, here this groove is moved to here, okay, so that time there is no groove here, the plunger is moved to like this, so that is this condition. Okay, however the gear selection, okay, so this is the normal neutral when we move to this words for the first gear, okay. I can explain clearly, okay. This is neutral, okay. This is neutral. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, reverse. Now you can. What will happen? This is now neutral. This is for first gear, okay. 2, 4, R. So this is the first gear, okay. The first gear, we move the shaft to this shirt, okay, here. So the groove also moved, okay. That time this bolt is locked with this normal surface and other side there is a groove. So inside here there is a plunger. So this bolt push this plunger and this plunger move to this shirt further, okay. This word further and is push the ball, okay, ball here, okay. Here you can see here what is the gear, okay. This is the first gear, okay. We move this shaft, okay, towards the first gear. Here first gear, okay. Here this is neutral. 2, 4. Here and the center shaft move this way. Okay, so here that third gear is activated. Okay, here that third gear is activated. Okay, move this way. That's why this groove is it's a normal position with the groove. Then it moves to this way. Okay, that time these balls are. Between the one side groove and other side normal surface, okay. So because of this plunger, the plunger will move. Because of the plunger and this, okay. Because of this plunger and this ball, okay. these three rods are not to clash. That means this 3 and 5 gear are not clashed. Okay, 1 to 3 gear are not clashed. Okay, if the distance is increased, sometimes this gear also confused. Okay, when we pull a gear level to first gear, sometimes this third gear is may activate. Okay, so this type of ball and plunger is a part of the interlock mechanism. Interlock mechanism. This gear are not clash. Okay, so there is a two mechanism between this rod and other is the gear shifter. Okay, there is a spring and both are applied on the gear rod. That is ball and spring, here plunger and ball. Okay, this is the interlock mechanism. Okay, okay, next we see the procedure. Okay, now we see the procedure part. Okay, in this procedure, okay, so we have the apparatus. Let's say they give the second gear boxes, identify the each gear set. Okay, we will do in the practical part. So the gear ratio also we have to find. So this power flow diagrams for each gear and gearbox, there is the power flow diagram for each gear of the gearbox. Prepare power flow diagrams for each gear of the gearbox. This is normally, this is the power flow diagram you have to draw. Okay, you have to draw here. So the neutral here, how this gear is power is transmitted in the neutral gear, first gear, second gear, third gear, fourth gear, and the reverse. Okay, that's no problem. You can choose the fourth gear, transmission of fifth gear, whatever you have to attach this diagrams under the observation part. Okay, you have to do this words in the observation part. Okay, for the gear ratio diagram. Also, you don't need to write row. If you are row by hand, you don't need to draw like this 3D. You can mention like this the wheel and shaft. Okay, then you have to point other color, use the other color pen to how is transmitted this power is transmitted. Okay, you have to you can draw the 2D diagrams. Okay, so how the gear selector mechanism is work, I already explained. When I am doing the practical, you can observe this thing. So this is the selector diagram for each gear as well. That you know, in the gear lever, you can see a selector diagram. Okay, you can search in the internet. Okay, first gear, second gear, third gear, fourth gear, fifth gear, reverse. Okay, you have to draw this selector diagram. Okay, here. So this is okay. This is okay. Observe the gear selector mechanism. This is no need to put anything in the your coursework, it's okay. This is just observation. You have to prepare. This is you have to prepare in the coursework and flow diagram. These are just observation. Huh? These three are just observation. You have to do in the coursework. You have to attach this selector diagram, flow diagram. I show. Okay. That have been shown the flow diagrams. Find each every gear ratio, including the reverse gear of provided gearboxes model. Okay, here for finding the gear ratio, we have to count our teeth. Okay, every gear wheel's teeth we have to count for the gear ratio. Okay. That is not possible. Okay, we have to take much time. Okay, so normally we have, I mean, each by teeth we have to count. Okay, so I give a data. Okay, I give a data. That's example for an example. Okay, I give a data here. Okay, the neutral gear wheel teeth. This teeth, everything I can give. Okay, so according to the data you have to find the gear ratio and other things. Okay, I will explain later. So instead of counting, okay, we can use this data for the second for the second procedure. Okay, gear ratio. Okay, gear ratio. So these three things are we have to do in the coursework: flow diagrams, this one, this one. Okay, each points will get mass. Okay, that's very important. So the gear, let's find how do we find the gear ratio. Okay, so we do one thing. Okay, this is actually in the coursework. Okay, the coursework, in the observation you don't write these things under the procedure part. Okay, flow diagrams, and then these three things. Okay, these three things you write under the observation part. Okay, these are the observation part. Okay, first two, sorry, this, not this one. Okay, this observation, first observation part. Okay, observation part, this is a calculation. Okay, gear ratio we have to do calculations. Okay, so I divided, please listen carefully. Okay, these two things. Okay, this thing, observation. Okay, you have to draw the power flow diagrams under the observation. Okay, prepare diagram or selector diagram you have to draw under the observation part. Okay, now observation is complete. Okay, not this one. Okay, observation is complete. After the observation, there's another part you have to do in the calculation. Okay, calculation. Okay, calculation part you have to do the gear, find the gear ratio. Okay, here you have to find the gear ratio. I will tell. Okay, the calculation part you have to find the gear ratio and everything, speed, torque. Okay, I will okay, I will tell. Okay, so this third you have to write under the calculation part. Now we are doing some calculations. Okay, we are doing some calculations. Okay, so for this are the basic calculation. Okay, I give some basic ideas, then we do we use these equations in our gearbox. Okay, this is a simple gear train. Okay, I already told. Okay, when it's rotate. Okay, what will happen? It's also going to rotate. So this is a input. This is input. This is output. Oh, this is a driver. This is driven. Okay, clear? Okay. So here TA means teeth. Okay. This teeth, number of teeth is 8. Number of teeth is TB is 32. Okay. T teeth. This N is rotational speed, that measured by RPM, revolution per minute. Okay. This is torque. The torque is measured by Newton meter. Okay. These things are you study in the school level. Okay. T means torque. So gear ratio. Okay. Here gear ratio. I already told. T out over in, T in. That means T driven. This is driven. I shortly from DN. This is TR, driver. Okay. Here we use the in out format. Okay. We use so in out. Okay. So the gear ratio, the teeth, number of teeth is come to like this. T out. T in. I already told, and the speed is I already told in the small, the larger number of teeth have low speed and okay, in the low amount of teeth have lower number of teeth have high speed. Okay, so this is not conversely proportional. Okay, so here T straightly, T out come to T in, T in straightly come to N out, sorry, T out, T N in, T in, N out. But the torque is different. I already told, when the speed is increased, okay, when the speed is increased, torque is reduced. I already told. Here we teeth this guy, yeah, this teeth this guy, teeth teeth in teeth is low. So acronym that T in is speed is high, n out is the is high amount of teeth, so the speed is low. But here this is this teeth, this small T is T number of teeth, capital T is torque. Okay, so again I already told, when we can achieve the maximum higher torque in lower speed. Okay, so here lower speed is this, wait, okay here n out, n out is lower, so T out is high, because when the lower speed we get higher torque out. Here n in is high. Okay, speed is high, also low torque is low. Okay, that's why, because of that this equation is derived. Okay, because of so you have to use this formula or this relation. Okay, so if you have know who the both teeth and input sheet, you have to find, you can find the output speed. Okay, this relation. Okay, so this is other equations, this is power. Okay, so we have to find the power also. So okay, so power 2 pi n is mean speed, torque is that is torque T 60. For an example, we can find the input power. This is the inner shaft. Okay, this is the inner shaft, this is the outer shaft, this is the counter shaft. Okay, the wheel is connected with here, in here some wheels. Okay, so here rotates. So the here power is input power, and here power out, okay, because of the transmission, okay, because of the transmission in out. Oh, at the same time, these two wheels, this is the power in, and after this is the power out, okay, both are same. This is the speed in, then out, torque in, here torque out, okay. So if you found the power, input power, what will happen? This speed is input speed, this torque is input torque, okay. If you need to find output power, this N is out, this T also out, okay. So we can find the input power and output power through this equation, okay. So we need to find the input speed and torque, okay, for the, okay, before that we have to find the speed and torque, okay. After you, we can find this is a power input output power, this is a input power, so this is the efficiency. Means we can give a power, input power, okay. For an example, 100 watt power, okay, power is measured by watt, okay, this watt, okay, 100 watt power we give. So after the process we can get 100 watt power. That means this machine is, this transmission is 100% efficiency, though no power loss. Sometimes we can get 85 watt. What will happen? We input is 100, this is 85, so what will happen? The efficiency is power output over input, or power output is 85 here, power input is 100 into 100 per percentage, okay, 100 per percentage, cut, so 85%, okay. So this both are same, the efficiency is 100, okay, this both. So this I do here, everything I clear. Okay, you just go gear ratio, how we can find, okay, gear ratio, what? This is a T out, that is T in, okay. So gear ratio 32 over 8, so gear ratio is 4, okay. That is 4 means, gear ratio 4 means, this actually this 4 means 4 into 1, okay, gear ratio, okay. Okay, gear ratio is 4, that means this is 4, this is 4, this is 1, okay. We have to reduce that, this comparison, 32 into 8, so we can reduce 4 into 1 or 1 into 4, okay. So in the 4 is outer wheel out, 1 is inner wheel, okay. 4 into this, we have to give a proportion, 4 into, so sorry, 4, not 4 into, 4 to 1, okay. Four to one is the gear ratio number of T. Okay, here. So, according to that, we can find the speed. Okay, gear ratio is T in into T out. Okay, gear. This is T out into T in. So this is proportional here. N in, okay, good, N out, okay, this conversionally proportional, okay. So gear ratio we already know 4, so input speed was given, okay, it's not no, 150 rpm here, input is 150 rpm, ratio we know, so we can find the NB. NB is 370.5 rpm, okay, 370.5 rpm, okay. So what will happen? So in the output wheel teats are high, so this so 1 to 4, okay, in the theta increase into 1 to 4, okay, here 1, here 4, 1 to 4, okay. So what will happen here? Theta increase 1 to 4, so the speed, what will happen to speed? Speed will 4 to 1, okay, inversely proportional, see, speed is 4 to 1, so that's why, okay, the teeth is going to increase, so the speed is going to, okay, quarter, okay, 4 times, it increased by 4 times, okay, so it's going to be quarter, okay, so that's 150, so quarter, so it's 180 to quarter, 375, okay, this is 4, this is 1, 4 to 1, okay, understand? So torque, okay, so input power, this also we know, we have to find the efficiency. Here they give the efficiency, so here efficiency is used here, okay. So this is just an example. So now I come to here, we have to do number of teeth, how we can do gear ratio, okay. Here first we find the gear ratio, okay, then we come to that teeth things, okay. So okay, gear ratio, so you know how to find the gear ratio. For an example, okay, I clearly explain. Input shaft, output shaft, counter shaft or lay shaft. For an example, now I am doing the first gear or something, okay. First we found the neutral gear, okay. The neutral gear, what will happen? This is the neutral gear, okay. Only I draw this related gear, huh? There are dumps, other gear wheels. This is the neutral gear, okay. So now the neutral gears are engaged, okay. So that time, okay, here first is neutral gear, okay, neutral gear, what, how we find it, okay. Here input driver, okay, this is the input driver, so this teeth number is 20, okay, output driver, this 20 is 49, okay. So we have to find the ratio, you have to do the calculations like this, okay. Gear ratio T out. Okay. The T in. Okay. T out over T1. So that's equal to, okay, what is T out? 49 into 20. Okay, this is a neutral gear, but normally we can we didn't find the neutral gear ratio. So you can do from the first gear ratio. I give this neutral gear ratio information to doing the first to five gears, okay, and the reverse gears also need to do it, because this neutral gear is always when first gear you apply the first gear or second gear, any gear, this neutral, this constant mesh, these two gears are always meshed or connecting, okay. So this gear ratio also we need, okay. That's why this gear ratio is for neutral gear, okay. So given gear ratio for neutral, okay, neutral gear ratio, this is okay. Now, okay, this for the information. First you have to know the neutral gear. The second we need to find the, now we start our work, okay, we have to find the gear ratio from first gear to reverse gear, okay. This is for your information, extra information. T out, okay. Now first gear, okay, I do only first gear. In the first gear situation, what will happen? In the first gear situation, okay, first gear, there is a gear here, okay, another here, and that here engages with here, okay. This is normally neutral here, it's come through and is connected, this is the output, okay. Here, okay, so here first gear tooth, okay, so input is 15, here input is here, this is 15, okay, output is 46, okay, okay. So our first calculation is finding the gear ratio. So we must find the first gear, okay. First gear, why? When the first gear, we need this gear also, okay. We cannot find only this gear, okay. This also in the full complete transmission, the path is like this. The path is like this, okay. So this total, the fourth gear wheels, we have to calculate. Already we calculate these two gears, okay. And the other, so that is neutral. So we again, so this is also we know, okay. Then we have to find the first gear, okay. First gear, 15 input, 46 is output, okay. So straightly we can do. This gear we also do like this, okay, but there are two separate couple of gears, okay. So the thing we have to do, okay, straightly we can write for an example here. This is neutral, in the neutral, okay, T neutral, D neutral for neutral, okay. But here another we can write separately, okay. Gear ratio first gear, okay, commonly T out, T out into T in common format. But here how is come? T out in the T, okay. T out in the T in. First we have to put these two equation, okay. T out in the T in. This key two key. 49 into 20. okay, then it's multiplied by, okay, then it's multiplied by, what is, we have to put these two gears, okay. Here what is input? Again we have to put the T out in T in, okay. T out is 46, T in is 15. So the first gear ratio is this total this is the total, okay. So 49 into 46, sorry, here I again here 49 into 20 into 46 into 15, okay, equal to, what is that, 49 into 46, okay. Okay, 2254. Here 20 into 50, 300. Okay, 300. So it's normally come to, okay, 7.5 into 1, okay. So we can directly give 7.5 into 1. The ratio is 7.5 to 1, okay, 7.5 to 1, okay. That's a gear ratio, okay. So for example, I only know neutral gear, you know, straightly you the second, okay. Okay. Now again I am doing the second gear, okay. For an example, I am doing the second gear. By adding it completely, you have to fill here, okay. This is a shaft. This is counter shaft, okay. This is for the gear teeth for the second, okay. Teeth is, so however this teeth is not changed, okay. So this in is 20, this is 49, here that's neutral, and here this is for second gear. So this is 23, input is 23, output is 43. So in the second gear, the gear is so fine, you can do slightly, okay. Second gear, okay, you have to give an underline, okay. Then gear ratio, okay, gear ratio is equal to T out over T in, okay, T out over T in. So you here do, okay, this is 49, okay. Here you can know this is T out, this is T in, okay. Again it's no 49 20 Okay, here I do gear ratio. Okay, here second gear heading. Okay, gear ratio T out over T in. So there 49, T out is 49, 20. Okay, 49, 20 into, okay, here other gear, okay, into here output is 49, there 49 into 23. So what will happen? Two one seven zero. 20 into 23, 460. So what is 2107 460 divided 460. So it's normally come to 4.51. Okay, under the one. Okay, so how we can give the gear ratio? Okay, it's come to here. Okay, how we can give the gear ratio? 4.1. So 4.5 into 1. Okay, 4.5 into 1. Okay, this is the gear ratio, second gear. So now you can do the I showed first and second. So you can do third, like these are common, 249. You have to apply this third gear, fourth gear, fifth gear. You can do this is 6 runs piece. So 6 here, why 6 here? There is no gear arrangement. Okay, I already told there is no wheel working. This shaft and this shaft straightly connected. Okay, so that's why look with input and output main shaft. So how there is no ratio, so we have to give a ratio. So here this 6 gear ratio is gear ratio 6 gear. Okay, what is that? Straightly we can write 1 to 1. This is a 1 to 1 ratio. Okay, the ratio is 1 to 1 because straightly, you know, gear transmission though straightly, so 1 to 1. Okay, you have to mention 6 1 to 1 and then we have to do reverse. Okay, this is the main thing. Reverse gear is different. Why? There are 5 gear. Okay, reverse gear is 5 gear. Why? Here normally 2 gear wheel, here 3, totally 5 gear. Okay, how we can do? Just be fun. Okay, so gear wheel I already have here. Okay, here for an example. Okay, you have to apply there. So I already told this is input. Okay, this is output wheel, this is idler wheel, idler. Okay, the mid wheel is idler wheel. Okay, so already we know now 49 and 20. Okay, 49 20 49 20. So this is the this setup. Okay, here there is two wheel, neutral wheel. Okay, something this neutral wheel is always coming. Okay, so this is 20 into 49. Okay, this 20, this 49 is always coming. Then moreover we have to find these three wheels, okay? So how we can apply? This ideal apply, this is input, this is output, okay? Normally you can the gear ratio, reverse gear ratio, okay? You can give here 49, 20, okay? T out, the T in, okay? Here I have T out, T in, okay? Into, multiply by, here there are two scenarios, okay? First is this IW, this is input, this is output, okay? This is input, this is output. So here, okay? Here input, here output, okay? So the wheels also given, this is a 20 wheel, this is 7, okay? 30. So this is a input wheel, idle wheel, this is output wheel. All teeth are, number of teeth are given in the table, okay? So 7. So here this is input, now this is output, okay? So we can find output is 20. Input is 7. This is for IEEE. This is for input. This connect with input and IEEE. So now we compare between these two wheels. This is input, that is output. Okay. Again, we can down this complete. We have to compare these two wheels. Okay. That time, this is input, this is output. This is output. Okay. So 30 into 20, okay. Okay, this is input, this is output. Then this is input, this is output. Okay, so the reverse gear ratio is total multiply, there is some amount. Okay, here also total multiply. Okay, okay, after we have to give into this. Okay, the ratio. Okay, so this is for the reverse gear. Okay, now I think this is also clear. So we can find the gear. Okay, now you know the how to find the gear ratio. Okay, input pulley, idler pulley, output pulley. Okay, so now you can do, okay, input pulley, output pulley, idle wheel. Okay, so now we can complete the gear ratio in the calculation part from first to reverse. Okay, now this is complete, this is the first part. The second thing, there are some other informations are here, the input shift, out input torque, efficiency. Okay, here for an example I am doing the first gear. So, okay, here I am doing the first gear, okay? So first you know first gear, okay? Consider the first gear. This is the shaft. This is the shaft, okay? I am doing the first gear. Okay. The first gear. Input is 1546. This is the number of pulleys. Okay, clear? These are the number of pulleys. Okay. Now, okay, we know the equations, okay? What are the equations? Teeth out, gear ratio, okay? Gear ratio, command. okay, tear ratio, T out, heel, T in or in. In speed is conversely proportion. So in heel, in out equal to T out, T in. Okay. Okay. This is 8. Weight and gear ratio. T out, T in. In out. The torque is torque out, torque in. Okay. So this is the data. Input speed. So input speed. See, this is a this is the input speed. 600 RPM. Okay. So we have to find the output speed. This is the output speed. Okay, in out we have to find. Okay, and the other thing we have to find the already we here torque. Okay, torque. Okay, this input torque is here. This sharp this input. This input torque is 100 Newton meter. Okay, 100 Newton meter. This torque is okay. So we have to find T out also. We have to find. Okay, the calculation part you have to find the in out, T out. Okay, first. So how we can do? Here you can see the speed is changed. Huh? Directly we cannot find this in out speed. Okay. First we have to find the this speed. Okay, two wheels. Okay, we have to take these two wheels. No, directly we can find. Okay, we know the gear ratio. Okay, directly we know the gear ratio. Okay, gear ratio we already find 7.5:1. Okay, the gear ratio, the first gear ratio you find. Okay, thus gear ratio is T out over T in. We already found. Okay, we already find 7.5:1. Okay, this is the ratio. Okay, so that is equal to what? T out over T. We already found the gear ratio 7.5:1. Okay, I already do how to find the gear ratio, the first gear. Okay, so here in we know input speed is n in. Okay, here relations n in. T out, T in, N in, we know 600. Okay, so we have to find N out. What is N out? Okay, N out is, so N out is come to this way. So in this 600 divided by 7.5. Okay. So 80. Okay, so the revolution per minute is 80. Okay, 600 is 7.5 is counted like this. So what is n out? N out is 600 into 7.5 here. Okay, equal to 80. So here we can find this RPM is 80. Sorry, the total Toyota. Here N out is 80 RPM. Okay. Okay, 80 RPM. So now we have to find the torque. Okay. T out. Okay. So the gear ratio is same. So T out, T in equal to torque. Torque also same. Torque out into torque in. Here torque out into torque in. Okay. So this is also we know 7.5 into 1 gear ratio we got. Okay. That is equal to the starting torque, input torque 100. So that is we know. We have to find the T out. This T out we have to find. Okay, what is that? T out is sorry, sir. Here there is a difference. Okay, why? Here T out, T in. Okay, here there is a T out. T out here. We have to find the T out, okay? T out, okay? You compare this equation with the, okay? T out we have to find. Here, T in we know, 100, okay? This is other thing, okay? T out, we have to find the, okay? So how? Here T out is 7.5 into 100, okay? So 750, yeah? 750 Newton meter, okay? 750 Newton meter. So T out is 750 Newton meter. So you can see here the first gear RPM is reduced before 600 RPM, then its output is 80 RPM. Okay, torque is 100, but in the here 750. Okay, so you can see. Okay, you can see when the speed is reduced, torque is increased. Okay, clear? Okay, so why we found the torque and out? Okay, we have another equations, power. Okay, here power is 2 pi n t over 60. Okay, so we have to find power input. Okay, now we don't know the power. Okay, so now clear? So I erase these things. Okay, how I found the torque and okay, this is combination also I erase. Okay, okay, so now you know that this is the equation. Okay, only we have the data for efficiency. Okay, so here P, we have to find the P in. Okay, so P in, power in means, okay, this common equation 2 pi n in T in 60. Okay, Sorry, I can't go here. So Pn 2 pi n in T in over 60. Okay. So here 2 pi, okay, 2 into pi into n in. N in is 600 RPM, okay. Okay, into T in, input 100, okay. 100. Okay, 100. So, 60. So, what is the value? So this is come to 600 280 watt. Okay, so we can reduce 2.68 kilowatt. Okay, so now we know the P in. Okay, but if 100 efficiency, this is the input power. If this is the input input power, if the efficiency is 100, what will happen? The output power also same, but here we can get 85% efficiency. Okay, okay, 85% efficiency. Okay, so what is efficiency? Efficiency is this symbol P out over P in. Okay, into 100, this gives by percentage. Okay, so here efficiency we know. Okay, efficiency we know. Okay, I erase it. P in we know. Okay, okay, efficiency we know. What is this? 85% P out. P out we have to find, okay. P out. P in we know. I use this watt. 6280, okay. 6280. Here 100, okay. But we can reduce this 100 here, and here we can straightly put 0.85. Okay, the 100, 0.85. So slightly we can write like this, 0.85, and remove the 100. Okay, 0.85 efficiency. So what is the P out? P out is, we have to multiply these things. Six two eight zero multiplied by 0.85. So the output power is 5338 volt. So this is the output power. So in your calculation part, after finding the gear ratio, you have to find, okay, speed, output speed. Okay, the black pen. You have to find the speed, okay, output speed, torque output. Okay, then use this equation, and you have to find the input power. Okay, input power. Then finally, use the efficiency, and you have to find the output power. Okay. So this input power is 6.28 kilowatt is here. Okay, but finally we got the sorry, this, oh, this is kilowatt, okay. We can find here, what is it, 5.338 kilowatt, okay. So, we take this, okay. 6,280 kilowatt in the input, and here the output is 5,338 watt, okay. So, these things you have to find, okay, after find the gear ratio, speed output, okay. Output speed, output torque, input power and output power using this efficiency. Okay, now clear? I think these are the things you have to do. Okay, then you have to do the discussion part, okay? We have to write the discussion part, okay? I hope this is the end of the tutorial. Now we started our practical with apparatus. This is our gearbox cut model. Now you can see, this side is clutch, here this side the transmission is connected, this is the gear lever. And here, this is the input shaft, okay? This is the output shaft, this is the counter shaft or lay shaft, okay? So you can see here, this is a synchronous type gearbox. So you can see these two wheels are neutral wheel. And here you can see a teeth, okay? This is clutching teeth of this speed gear. There is another ring is there. This is a synchronous ring, I already told. This is the shift fork, okay? This is a sleeve, synchronized sleeve, this is, okay? This is move this word and that word, okay? So, here you can see another, how this is a neutral position. Okay, this is the gear rod, okay? There are three rods, huh? You can see there are three rods. So, now you can see how when I select the first gear, what will happen in the gear selector, okay? Okay, this is the first gear, this is second, this is third, this is fourth, and here this is the fifth, okay? So you can see how it works. So this springs control this, the play of this gear lever, and you can see there are some grooves. I already told in the gear interlock mechanism. Here you can see the gear. Okay. The other thing. Okay. Now you can see how it works. Okay. So you can see when I put up the gear. You can see here. This is the first gear. This move this way, okay? This is synchronized sleeve is move this way. When I put the second clutch, this move this way, okay? Now the third gear, you can see here. This move this way, okay? And the fourth gear, this move the other side, okay? And this is the fifth gear, as you cannot see visibly. Now you can see them. Reverse gear, okay, the power is come to like this. This is a neutral gear and this is the input pulley. So this is the idler wheel and this is the output pulley, okay? So normally in the this power is transmitted to this from input to idler and now idler to output. So when we select the reverse gear, this idler move and is engaged with this input wheel, okay? Now you can see when I put the reverse, this move and this is engaged with the idler pulley, okay? Okay. So now and you can see here the wheels, okay? Here normally this is the angle, this teeth is, this is the angle of helical cut teeth, and here and the reverse key that is normally is, this is a straight teeth
Okay. So I hope this practical will be useful for you. Okay. And this is the end of the practical. Okay, thanks.